This is Judy Tyler. Unless you are a fan of Elvis Presley, you've probably never heard of her. She was his leading lady in jazz rock. Judy was born Judith May Hess on October 9, 1932 in Manhattan, New York. Her father played trumpet for Paul Whiteman and Benny Goodman, and her mother was a former Ziegfeld Follies dancer. Judy spent her teen years in Teaneck, New Jersey. During her time there, she studied ballet, music, and acting. In 1949, she won a Miss Stardust beauty contest and danced with a chorus line at the Copa in New York. Her acting career started with a small part on a children's show named The Howdy Doody Show.
Friendly game. I've been as happy as a bird. You are sure to feel the same when you say those magic words. So when a buddy shakes your hand, be sure as soon as he takes your hand, you let him know you think he's grand. Just yell.
After that, for 2 years, she got a part in the Rodgers and Hammerstein musical Pipe Dream. Not too much information on her private life. She married Colin Romoff in 1950, who worked mostly behind the scenes in the music department and as a hairdresser. They were divorced in 1956. Judy married actor Gregory Lafayette on March 31, 1957. The end of 1956 and early 1957 was a busy time for Judy as her acting career began to take off after being featured in Life magazine as a rising Broadway talent. Bop Girl Goes Calypso was the title of Judy's first movie in which she had star billing, a low-budget musical. She was cast soon after Bop Girl was finished as Elvis Presley's leading lady in Jailhouse Rock. This was a really good part for Judy, who showed what a good actress she was. Judy must have felt really excited and happy how her career was going when she and her husband Gregory were driving back to New York 3 days after filming was completed. They were driving on Highway 30 near Willcox, Wyoming, when her husband swerved the car to avoid hitting a vehicle that pulled out in front of them. Judy was killed instantly when another vehicle hit them. Her husband Gregory died the next day. He was only 19 years old. Judy was 24.
What happened in the fight and the fact that you wouldn't hit him? I think it was wonderful, Vince. It was an act of true love. Yes, it was. Don't be afraid to love, Vince. Because I love you.